Today I'm going to show you a quick fix for the dreaded C5 Corvette fuel leak. You might have a engine code P0440, which is an evap leak. You might have a raw fuel smell. Or if you're unlucky, you might be dumping fuel all over the ground when you try to top off your tank. These are all symptoms of the same problem. Now the vehicle I'm working on is a 2003 Z06, but this should work for any 97 to 03 C5 Corvette that does not have the metal rigid crossover tube. So here's a few things you'll need to get the job done. Now you're gonna need a thin strip of sandpaper. I used 150. It's pretty tight quarters. You'll be working under the car. This is a band of rubber from the inner tube off of my mountain bike. This is a 26 by 2 1/8. This was an old tube that was discarded. This is the new hose clamp that I'll use to replace the inferior factory one. And the size is 36, which is a 46 to 70 millimeter. And that was the factory hose clamp. This is a 7 and 8 millimeter socket. You'll need the 7 millimeter to remove the factory hose clamp. And you'll need the 8 millimeter most likely to install the new hose clamp. Tape measure comes in handy for a couple of reasons that you'll see. Now, when I first saw the code for evap leak, of course I replaced the fuel cap, which is fine because it was 16 years old. So I really don't mind that that did not fix the problem. Here's where the tank's located. The one we're gonna be working on is right behind the driver's seat. But the repair we're gonna do is easy because you don't need to remove the tank. We're just gonna remove the connector tube from the left tank. And to do that, you wanna go straight in from the gas cap. So when you go under the car, you're gonna come straight up behind the driver's seat. And I'll show you the crossover tube with the original factory hose clamp on. Right after the fuel dump at the gas station, I went up inside and I could see raw fuel hanging off the bottom of the crossover tube. And it was pretty clearly coming from the clamp, so I knew that's where the leak was. Now here's a tank with all the vacuum lines attached. Now this next tank has the vacuum lines removed, but it's important to remember that the vacuum lines are used by the vehicle to test the fuel system on the car. Periodically, under certain conditions, the vehicle puts a vacuum on the fuel system using a pump that's located on the engine. And if the fuel system can't hold a vacuum pressure for the correct amount of time, then that throws the evap codes. Now, a typical radiator neck is very smooth, gives the radiator hose something nice to seal to. The necks on these gas tanks have huge casting errors, and that surface is a very likely leak point. And this not only causes a vacuum leak, but as you fill the tank and the fuel rises up into the crossover tube, then you have a gasoline leak as well. They did strengthen the neck by putting a metal band in there, so when it does come time to tighten things down, you can put a fair amount of torque on there without damaging it. But if you look at the factory hose clamp, which by the way, it's glued to the crossover tube, so you just pull it off, it's not gonna harm anything. It's got a rigid bridge on here that keeps it from conforming to the surface when you're tightening it down, and that's part of the leak problem. So if you look at this replacement hose clamp, you can see that it's much better able to conform to the surface of the neck when you're tightening it down. When you're under the car, it's going to be pretty tight. That's why you want to have a band of sandpaper like this. You can just grab it on each end. It's going to take a lot longer than this, but I'm just going to demonstrate here and show you that you can work it for a little while and then just feel those castings until they're nice and smooth. And once you get those fairly smooth, then you're going to put the band on. Now you'll notice that the clamp surface is only about 1 inch long, but I cut the tube a little bit longer than that. And the reason is, although it looks like it's too long, when it stretches over the neck, because it's stretched out, it magically shortens, and that's what you want. So it's a perfect fit on that clamp surface. And of course you want to cover as much of that clamp surface as possible. Make sure all the folds are out of the tube so you get a nice fit. And what you'll do is you'll put the hose clamp on the crossover tube, and then you'll slide the crossover tube, of course, onto the neck that has the inner tube band on it. And then you'll use your 8 millimeter to tighten that up. I'd film that under the car, but it's a little bit tight under there, so I'm showing you as carefully as I can with this tank that's out of the vehicle. So now let's go under and have a look. Now at this point, you'll see everything in place. I've got the inner tube band on the gas tank neck, and you'll see the crossover tube with the new hose clamp ready to tighten. Now I'm not measuring torque here, but I'm definitely putting it very snug. And remember, you've got the band of inner tube under there helping to seal, so you don't need to over tighten this. You also don't want to damage the crossover tube. And we are done. So now what you're looking at is the same spot after about 1 month of use. So I've had a lot of freeway drives. The engine light never came back on, no engine code, no fuel smell, and of course no fuel spills. So this ended up being a really reliable repair. If this helps you out, please do give a thumbs up and subscribe for future videos. And if you know anybody else trying to do this, please do share this video. Thanks for watching.